in Vegas. This is Mozilla Fun. Okay, students, once again, we can discuss about skeletal muscles. Skeletal muscles means the muscles which is attached to the bone is called skeletal muscles. With the help of the tendons, they are commonly attached to the bones. But the muscle, skeletal muscles is commonly present in the form of bundle, and each bundle is called fascicle. And each bundle is commonly consists of so many muscle cells are there. What is the name of the muscle cells? Muscle cells in fascicle. Muscle cells in the fascicle, what we can call? Muscle fiber. That is called muscle fibers. Very, very important, students. Like these are called muscle fibers. Something like muscle fibers. Muscle fibers are muscle cells. Okay? Fish are bleeding. Very, very important. Fascicle under bundle. Fascicles are connected by elastic connective tissue under that is called fascia. But every fascicle is consisted of a group of the muscle cells. What is the name of the group of muscle cells? Muscle fibers. Clear? You get now? Every muscle fiber. One muscle fiber for your understanding, I'm drawing very elongated diagram like this. This is about the one muscle fiber. Muscle fiber diagram. Okay? This muscle fiber, I'm completely drawing elongated. Every muscle fiber is completely covered up by plasma membrane is called what? Sarcoplasma. Next one, cytoplasm is present. What is the name? Sarcoplasm. This is sarcoplasm. In this sarcoplasm, so many endoplasmic reticulums are there. Endoplasmic reticulum like this. What is the name of this endoplasmic reticulum? Sarcoplasmic reticulum. Okay, students? And very, very important now, so many nuclei also present. I already said skeletal muscles are commonly showing which one? Syncytia. Meaning multinucleated condition. You see, like this one, many nuclei are present. This condition is called the mass. Multinucleated condition. It is also called syncytia. Okay, next, in the sarcoplasm, so many fibrous substances are present. These fibrous substances are parallel with each other. So many filamentous structures are parallel with each other. Can you speak that one? What is the name of the parallelly arranged filamentous structures? That is called myofibrils. This is called myofibrils. Myofibrils. It is parallelly arranged inside the sarcoplasm. Sarcoplasm nalli. So many parallelly arranged filamentous structures are there. That filamentous structures are called myofibrils. These myofibrils, they are having so many alternatively arranged dark and light bands are present like this one. Dark and light bands are commonly present. Okay? So, myofibrils is commonly consist of. So, it's about the myofibrils. Myofibrils. Commonly contain alternately arranged. Dark and light bands are present. Both are arranged alternatively with each other. So here we have to discuss about first dark bands. Dark band is completely formed by a special contractile protein. Speak out, what is the name of it? Myosin. Very, very important. This is called myosin protein. And light color band is formed by which one? Actin protein. So both are contractile protein and the nidra. Again, when you are eating the muscles or when you are eating the mutton and chicken, totally we are getting that from the protein A. Why? Because major important proteins are they actin and myosin. The actin and myosin proteins are present in this myofibrils only. The myofibrils itself only, actin and myosin is there. But in this one, we have to discuss about the different type. The bands being a partition of the letters, we have to discuss some in detail. Okay? talking about our bands. So this is about the dark color band. Now this is called as a dark color band. The next term, here also one more dark color band I'm drawing. So dark color band, and then what it represents of dark color band, and then this much. Yes. Okay. Yes. Dark color band is myosin. Protein is formed that one, and this band is also called which one? The A band. So we can call A band. Next, light color band is produced by or formed by actin protein. What we can call I band. You already know the full form of the A band. A for anisotropic band. That is the wrong. And I for isotropic band. So isotropic band, attraction actin protein. I band, attraction actin protein. A band, attraction myosin. Okay, sir. A band, actin protein. And the protein. Don't think like that one. A for actin alla. A for anisotropic. The anisotropic band is formed by myosin. Myosin. That is. Okay, students. Okay. Okay, now I completely drawn that one. This is about the myosin. Myosin. This is about the dark color band is there. This is called myosin. This is called myosin. Okay, na? Okay. Okay, next term. I'm drawing about the light color band also. Completely drawing. This is about the light color band. The light color band is formed by actin protein. This is about the actin protein. But actin protein is consist of so many subunits are there. So many components are there in the actin. Like this. It is present. Later I can draw a diagram. So this is so light color band. Suppose the light color band. Okay? Next here also, active protein is present. Here also active protein is present. Same here also active protein.
Joe.
What is meant by H-zone? H-zone and rate is during the resting time. During the resting time, some portion of the A band cannot be covered by which one of I band. That is what we can call H-zone. H-zone. So H-zone, it is a portion of A band. It is a portion of A band. It is a portion of A band which is not overlapped by. Not overlapped by which one of A band. Sorry, I band. It's a portion of A band which is not overlapped by I band. But H zone we can observe during the resting or relaxation time, or we can observe in the contraction time.
Relaxation.
Simple. Okay. Next, sarcomere. What is meant by sarcomere? The gap between the two Z lines are what we can call sarcomere. And which one is the structural and functional unit? Very good. It is the structural and functional unit of what? Muscle contraction. Very important. Many times repeated in your competitive exams. Yeah, the structural and functional unit of muscle contraction that is sarcomere. Hi students, okay. So myofibrils, we will discuss more today, students. Myofibrils, okay. Myofibrils, normally it is plane, but if you are observed in the compound microscope or in electron microscope, it will be showing so many striations. These striations get caused because of the two major contractile protein name of actin and myosin. So actin and myosin present in the myofibrils. Actin and myosin only, first of all, myosin formation agide e band ge what we can call A band ante kirtla. A band full form enappa anisotropic band. Next, alternative with anisotropic band, which one is there? I band is present, correct? This is called I band. I band is formed by which protein? Got the clarity, students? Okay. Okay, next. And which line is completely dissecting that from the I bands? Z line, not the graph. One of the elastic fibrous membrane is a elastic fibrous membrane. It is dividing that one. It is dividing that one, the I band. So I band divide Martha is the Z line and the Tilgur. Same here also. Idu I band A, Idu I band. Both I bands need completely dissect Martha is the Z line. Dissect Martha is the Z line. Correct? It is one of the elastic fibrous membrane. Clear? Okay, next one. One more line also there. Through this line and that is called A bands are attached to what the name of this line? M line. But M line is a which type of line? Like is a fibrous membrane. Next, elastic fiber is fibrous membrane. Which one is elastic fiber now? Z line. Which one is normal fibrous now? M line. A bands attached to what? A bands. Next one. Z line which bands are attached to what? I bands. Same here also like that one. Now here Z line is there, here also Z line is there. The gap between the two Z lines are what we can call sarcomere. One muscle normal stage idiya, contraction agidiya anta, how we can find out? sarcomere only. That is, sarcomere is the structural and functional unit of muscle contraction. Correct? Muscle contraction. Okay, there is sarcomere length kadame aayitu andre yes muscle contract aayipadla. Adhe sarcomere length normal ide andre yes muscle ella relaxation ide anta artha. Okay na? So relaxation time nalli both z lines are in normal condition or normally position. Plus very very important the h zone also. What is meant by h zone? H zone andre eno Henson zone ante kerivi. What is meant by Henson zone? The portion of A band which is not overlapped by I bands. Correct already. I bands are literally overlapping that from the A band or not? Okay. Mainly they are overlapping the edges or they are overlapping the center of edges only they are overlapping. That's why the center part of the A band is not covered by I band. That part is a what we can call. Clear students. So H zone particular agide andre yes muscle contraction illa muscle relaxation ide antha naavu tilkobodu. Three words are like you are remembering, so automatically you can understand how the muscle contraction takes place, how the muscle relaxation takes place. You can easily understand. Okay, next term, we can discuss in detail of how I band is made, how does A band is made. We have to discuss in detail. First of all, I band. Come on, I band is formed by which protein? Yes, actin protein is formed that on the I band. Next one, actin. The actin protein is formed of which color band? Light color band. Correct. So light color band is formed that one. Or light band is formed. The light band is one more name is I band. I band is formed of I band. This is called I band. And the I band diagram I am drawing big size. So now this is about the I band structure. This is about the I band structure, is it? So I band. I don't neglect that on the diagram also. Why? Because for a decreased linear KCT level, they can give two diagrammatic questions in your KCT every exam. So maximum chances are there to give that one the diagrammatic questions. But in NEET, only just 1% of choice is there to give the diagrammatic question. But in KCT, they can give the choice. Compulsory. Every year they are giving the two diagrammatic questions. One is from botany and one is from zoology concept they are giving. That's why when you are reading, don't leave the diagram. Okay, no? You should completely practice that one, the labeling part also. Labeling part also you have to remember. Otherwise you have to lose your marks. You see, this is one of the actin protein. Actin protein. The actin protein mele. Are you observing here? This is actin protein. Tropomyosin. And third one is tropomyosin and troponin. These are about the three components are present. If they point in your examination, which one is not the component of the actin filament or actin protein? What are the components of the actin protein? If you remember, which one is not? You can easily find out. Students, the first F actin bucket discuss model. F actin, filamentous actin and the grid. F for filamentous actin. Okay? Two filamentous actins are there. These are helically wound with each other. Helically wound to each other. That is called as F actin. And each F actin, come on now. Each F actin is completely made of many chala monomeric monomeric globular proteins. Monomeric globular proteins are globular molecules. Idra what is that? This is about the everyone is a globular protein at the beginning. Okay, how many F actins are present? This is totally called F actin. That these are called as F actin. F actin for one minute. How many filamentous actins are helically bound with each other? Two filamentous. But every filamentous actin, are you observing that one? It is made up of so many monomeric units are there. It looks like a beads, string of bead like structure. But every globular protein or every round shaped one is we can call globular protein at the given. Okay, students, this is F actin. The second one is called tropomyosin. Tropomyosin is also one more filamentous structure. It is also same. Two filamentous structures. It is also runs parallel to whom? Runs parallel to F actin. जो तुझे parallel आ गया था. Is run parallel to. This is called the mass. This is what the filamentous structure is. The filamentous structures are completely run parallel to F. F-actin जो तुझे parallel आ गया था. This is called tropomyosin. Here also, how many tropomyosins are there? Two tropomyosin, not one, two tropomyosin, is it? This is about the one tropomyosin, no? And this is the one more tropomyosin. Two tropomyosins are there. The students, okay, no? Here also, F actins are two is there, and that is called tropomyosins also, two is there. This is about the one, and this is about another one. Careful. Okay, now two filamentous actins are there, and two filamentous tropomyosins are there. Here are students. Okay, the third type is what we can call troponin. Okay, here a group of which one? A group of three subunits. We can call them as troponin. But it is present on where? It is present on. Is present on tropomyosin at regular intervals, very 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 important. Regular intervals, it is completely present on the tropomyosin. Okay, observing here, this is about the tropomyosin. Regular intervals, it is present in the tropomyosin. See this flow. Three subunits. Now I can speak that one. It is not there in textbook, but you should learn that one. What are the three subunits are there? Same here also three subunits. Here also three subunits are there. Plus, these three subunits are. What are the three subunits? The first one is called the mass. Okay, TC T and then we got. Andre troponin T and the. TCI, and third one is called TC. Okay, C and the. So three types of subunits: TCT, TCI, TCC. If TCT is completely helpful for, okay, is completely helps to binds to tropomyosin. Tropomyosin, jodi gaye, quite a big number. It inhibits inhibits myosin binding sites. Attached to calcium ions. components is there. Three components and the first gate DMT and S. This is called DMI as a this is called DMC and S. Prati troponin only these are for the three components. Okay, next I can give that one explanation of these three subunits. Either only first subunit is number DMT. Now this is called the mass. Troponin, yaru jothege bind aagutte tropomyosin jothege correct ah this is called the mass tropomyosin anta helidalla this is called tropomyosin jothege troponin attach aagbekandre TNT use aagutte yes it is binds to tropomyosin troponin function yes very important troponin mass that one okay active binding sites of myosin is having the head region like this one during the muscle contraction this about the myosin can bind with the whom during the muscle contraction myosin is bind with whom but the myosin actin jothe bind aagbekandre kamada actin mele which binding sites irbeku myosin binding sites irbeku so myosin binding sites present on the actin that binding site that myosin binding site who is masking Troponin is masking, correct? Troponin is masked that on the active binding sites of whom? On active protein. But troponin is contained that on the three subunits. These three subunits only come out. Which one is masking that one? TNT na, TNI or TNC na? TNI. Okay, it is inhibits. It is inhibits the myosin binding sites on the actin. Why? Because they are only masking that one. They are only masking that one, the myosin binding sites. Who is masking the myosin binding sites? Okay, next one. Who is provide the site for attachment of the calcium ions? So that's why. C for calcium. I for inhibition. One more T for tropomyosin. Finish long. Today, actin protein. Actin protein is also one type of contractile protein under it. Hello, the contractile proteins are mainly present in myofibrils. And the special filamentous structures present inside the muscle fiber. Correct. Muscle fiber. Walagade. Which one is present? Myofibrils. Myofibrils. Walagade. Two types of the contractile protein. What is the name first? Actin structure. Once again, I can review that one. Okay. So, actin protein, right? This consists of the three particles. Three components are present in the structure. First of all, which one? F actin. Second one, tropomyosin. What is the third one? Troponin. But which one is having the globular monomers? globular monomers are presenting. In fact, this is going to be very, very important, students. Globular monomers are commonly present in effect. Eka, which one is a thread-like structure which is parallel to that from the effect in? Okay, last one is, which one is? Yes, that is troponin. Troponin is nothing but it is made up of how many subunits now? Three subunits. It is present on the tropomyosin at regular intervention. Now, how much difference is there? Say much difference also. We can observe that regular constant intervals come to be. It is present on the tropomyosin. Confusion madikara. Tropomyosin is present on troponin. Troponin present on tropomyosin. This is important. Plus three subunits are present in the troponin. What is the function of the troponin? Simple one. Troponin is mass the active binding sites for same. Next, we can go for one more protein. One more contractile protein also present. What is the name? Also careful, RPS. This is a textbook. Okay, easy. But I will not confuse. ನಾವು ಬರೆದ್ರೆ ಸಿಂಪಲ್ ಮೆಥಡ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ನೀವು ಒನ್ ಸೈಡ್ ಬರ್ಕೋರಿ ಇರುವಾಗ ಕನ್ಫ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಇರಲ್ಲ. ಓಕೆ, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್ ಈಸ್ ಮಯೋಸಿನ್ ಪ್ರೋಟೀನ್. ಮಯೋಸಿನ್ ಆಕ್ಟಿನ್ ಈಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ದಟ್ ಒನ್. ಸೊ ಆಕ್ಟಿನ್ ಫಿಲಮೆಂಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ದಟ್ ಒನ್ ದ ಲೈಟ್ ಕಲರ್ ಬ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಅಂತ ಇದೆ. ಬಟ್ ಮಯೋಸಿನ್ ಈಸ್ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ದಟ್ ಒನ್ ಡಾರ್ಕ್ ಕಲರ್ ಬ್ಯಾಂಡ್. ಡಾರ್ಕ್ ಕಲರ್ ಬ್ಯಾಂಡ್, ಈ ಡಾರ್ಕ್ ಕಲರ್ ಬ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಏನಂತ ಹೆಸರಪ್ಪ? ಈ ಬ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಅಂತ ಹೆಸರು. It's also called the mass A band. Our myosin we can discuss it. Go either up. It's about the myosin. This myosin. This myosin is commonly consist of. Okay? So myosin is about the protein. How the structure is there, just you want to watch it. So this is about the two types of. Myosin also completely made up of. Myosin also one of the polymer. It is a polymer of which one? Neuromyosin. Neuromyosin. Very, very, very important. Myosin, it is from the dark color band. A dark color band we can call anisotropic band. The anisotropic band is formed by many neuromyosin. So many neuromyosin is allowed together. They will form myosin. Clear, students? Mathe, e neuromyosin. So each neuromyosin, this is about the neuromyosin. Each neuromyosin is consist of how many parts are there? Two parts are there. The first one is called the mass, a head with a short arm. Head with a short arm on the body. And the second one is called the mass. Which one not? Each neuromyosin consists of two parts. Two parts are commonly present. Two parts are present in the neuromyosin. Head with the short arm is present. Second one is called tail. But literally, which one is called heavy neuromyosin? Which one is called light neuromyosin? Head with the short arm is what we can call heavy neuromyosin. Heavy neuromyosin. Very, very important students. Heavy neuromyosin. Heavy neuromyosin. Shortcutly, what we can call? Instrument. And tail is also part of the mass. Which one now? Light neuromyosin. Light neuromyosin. The light neuromyosin may LMM. This is a lot of confusion. The index book is not a lot of confusion. But it is not a lot of confusion. You can make a special time. Tablet element one side of your textbook, then no confusion at all. Okay? For your understanding, now, here one neuromyosin, here two neuromyosins are there. Here one neuromyosin is there, but another neuromyosin I am completely drawing at another side. Another side means what? You go this side, I am drawing. You go another neuromyosin diagram, this side I am drawing. Like, yeah, this is the neuromyosin, this is the neuromyosin. But every miromycin is consist of, yes, okay, no? This is what the miromycin of, neuromycin is consist of what? What is the name of this part of? Head. This is what we can call head and leg. Plus, this is what we can call short arm. And this is what we can call our leg. The head with the short arm, what we can call heavy miromycin. This is heavy miromycin. Yeah, the tail is what we can call a light miromycin. The tail is now light miromycin. Understood, students? Okay, you know. Again, head region. Head region also consists of again two more sides are present. Two more sides are present in the head region. Can you speak out what the name of the two more sides? This is called actin binding site. This is called actin binding site. And the second one, you know? ATP binding site. This is called ATP binding site. Actin binding site and the ATP binding sites, they are both the two binding sites. You can observe in the head region are heavy neuromyosin. So actin mainly, this is about the actin protein. Actin protein mainly which binding sites are there? Myosin binding sites. Myosin mainly which binding site? Why? Because, you see, here also this one is also called the mass, you see, it's about the one of the head region, it is also one of the head region. One head region is this side, another head region is this side. During the muscle contraction time, come on, the myosin head is bind with whom? Myosin head is bind with whom? You know the mechanism of muscle contractions. So muscle contraction time nalli myosin head completely bind with the actin filament. Ekandre ee actin filament or actin protein mele which one is there? Myosin binding sites are there. Myosin binding sites here, actin binding sites are here. That's why myosin binding site, actin binding site, both are attached during the muscle contraction time and they are pulling. Here are students. Here Ashtin, this is about the myosin. Second repeating, myosin, it is one of the major, one more contractile protein present in the muscles. It is from the dark band. Dark band is also called which one? Next, myosin. Myosin is made up of, or myosin is a polymer of which one? Several neuromyosin. Several neuromyosin. Every neuromyosin is consist of how many parts are there? Two parts are present. What are the name of the two parts? Head with the short arm, second one is called tail. Head with the short arm, what we can call? Heavy miromycin. The tail is what we can call? Light. Here so many miromycins are there. So many miromycins are there. Here also there and this one also there. But which one is from the dark band? That is called light miromycin is from the dark band of? Or heavy miromycin is from the dark band of? Which one? Light, because light miromycin under nothing but in the tail. Correct? Tail is present here like this. And head with the short arm is there, you know, it is slightly projected to outside. Which one is slightly projection to outside? Head with the short arm. Correct? So all miromycins are head is completely formed that one, the thick or dark band. Dark band is completely formed by the tail of the all miromyosins. Next one, you see, this is about the light miromycin, it is called heavy miromycin. But which one is slightly projected to outside? Heavy miromycin. And it will be showing that one of the small angle also showing. Can you speak out that one? What is the name of this small angle? Yes, that is called cross R mandalikra. R mandalikra, nothing but in the angle. With a little angle, the head is completely focused to outside like this. Looks like a Buddha of Nagara Havu. Correct? It is a, looks like a one of the snake. Hood Tara is a snake tail again. Now, light miromycin and the Gindra. Hood again. Head. Head again. Now, what we can call? Heavy miromycin. The students. Okay? But which one is perfectly from the dark band? Dark band is formed by light miromycin. But here only one miromycin only is there. So many miromycins are there. All miromycins, tails are completely combined like this one. but their head with the short arm are projected to all side like this. Head with the short arms are projected to all side. Like this. That's right. So this is about the dark band, light band. Dark band, light band, dark band, light band. Either half. They are present alternatively. They are present alternatively. This one also. Okay. Myosin structure also. Okay, go for mechanism of muscle contraction. Okay. Mechanism of muscle contraction is also called which one? Sliding filament theory. Sliding filament theory is mainly explained mechanism of muscle contraction according to this theory. Okay? Thin filaments are sliding over thick filaments. Students, this part is the issue. Thin filaments should underline or should highlight. Thin filaments are sliding over the thick filament according to this theory. But which one is called thin filament? Which one is called thick filament? Okay? So thin filaments and dakshina, that is about? Yes, thin filaments are that is called actin or I bands. So I bands are completely sliding over the which one now?
A bands.
But it's really very, very important. There is no change in the structure of which band of? A band. There is no change in the structure of A band, but changes occurring which band of I band nalli mathra changes varuthe ee points ella highlight maadkodra ee points bittinga vere points enum major focus maadala idha yes ige now muscle contraction mechanism first gottagbekandre first of all generally in our body muscles are contraction and relaxation is under the brain, correct? So totally two types of neurons are present in our body, two types of the neurons present in our body which is helpful for muscle contraction, muscle relaxation. Name out the two types of the neurons. Sensory neurons and sensory neurons, they have to send the impulses from tissues to brain or CNS. But motor neurons, yes, they will completely send the signals from brain to tissues. Same muscle contraction time maybe also, which neurons are play an important role, that is called sensory neurons or motor neuron? But motor neurons is connected to, suppose, these are the muscle of the tilkota, this is about the one of the muscle of the tilkota. From the central nervous system, come on, the neurons are directly connected to that one. This is called muscle fiber of the tilkota. Muscle fiber. What is the other name of muscle fiber? Muscle cell is covered by sarcolemma. Sarcolemma is present. Now, this is called motor neuron. This is the motor neuron ending is there. This is about the ending. Correct? Okay? This is called nerve ending and the periphery. The nerve ending is commonly having a global structure is present. What is the name of that global structure? Synaptic nerve. Next, where the motor neurons are connected to that from the sarcolemma of the muscles, we can call motor unit and the periphery. This is called motor unit. Okay, students? Motor unit. Okay? Or it is also called neuromuscular junction andre enu karbodu neuromuscular junction andre where the neurons are connected to the muscles of the okay muscles of the body, that is called neuromuscular junction. First the impulses are completely carried by motor neurons into the sarcolemma. This is nothing but sarcolemma of the muscle fiber. Okay, so when the impulses enter into that from the end of this, automatically they have to release that one. Come on, one of the neurotransmitter. Can you speak out what the name of the neurotransmitter? Acetylcholine. acetylcholine is we can call which one of neurotransmitter. Generally, neurotransmitter, it is temporarily stored in the vesicles like structure, you know. What is the name of this vesicle? Synaptic vesicles and directly synaptic vesicles. Synaptic knob olagade matte globose like structures is present. What is the name of this globose structure? Of synaptic vesicles. Now when the infancy is reached upon the up to the synaptic knob, immediately synaptic knob is released upon the synaptic vesicle. Our synaptic vesicle nalli kamanda, which one is come to outside? So acetylcholine, it will attach to that one the sarcolemma. It will attach to the sarcolemma immediately. It causes which potential? Of action potential. Action potential they developed on the sarcolemma. So when the action potential developed upon, it leads to that one muscle contraction. Only the muscle contraction should happen. Clear? So action potential is enter into that one the muscle cell. Then immediately already said that one in the sarcoplasm, which one is there? Sarcoplasmic reticulum, it is releasing the which ions?
Calcium
ions. The calcium ions will be go and bind to that one the, which one of? It will be go and bind. Suppose here I am completely drawing that one, which is troponin. Troponin anta telkoda. This is mechanical. So this is called as tropomyosin anta telkoda. Tropomyosin male, which one is present? What is the name of this one?
Tropomyosin.
Now the calcium ions are completely comes and bind to the which subunit of troponin? TNC. Jodhike bind out. TNC jodhike calcium ions evang bind out. So immediately so much of conformational changes are occurs in the troponin and tropomyosin. Which changes are occurs? Conformational changes or morphological changes. These morphological changes engendre ee troponin, it will be moved to one side like this. When the troponin is moved to one side like this, one only troponin illide first, but illi varutava kaarendre conformational changes. When the troponin is completely showing the conformational changes, what is already happened? The myosin binding sites are there on the actin filament is there, you know, it will be open. Correct? This has become unmasking and the kendra. Correct? During muscle contraction time, which one is occurs? Unmasking occurs. But naturally, which one is masking the binding sites?
Troponin.
Correct? But troponin, jothege yavaga calcium ions bind aagutho, immediately troponin sarpa move aagutappa. Move aag takshana, immediately actin filament mele myosin binding sites expose aagutte. Exposing in our what we can call unmasking and the get to be unmasking and the get to be. Okay? Ega myosin male actin binding site is a actin male myosin binding site is a once again actin male myosin binding site myosin male actin binding site. Here to both are suitable to each other. That's why immediately the myosin can bind with the boom. But myosin actin jothege bind aagbekandre compulsory ATP energy useful aagutara. This got ATP energy use aagutara. But ATP energy use aagnalli first of all ATP is dissociated to form which one of ADP plus phosphate plus which one of energy. Ago aa energy ne is useful for the binding of the myosin with whom? The binding of the myosin with whom?
Actin.
That's why what they will form? Cross bridge formation. This is called cross bridge formation. Thank you today. So can I see concept I completely drawn here? Understood? This part I completely drawn here, but only one myosin head only I drawn here. One head only I drawn. Clear? Now the myosin head is bound with the actin. Finally, they will form a bridge-like structure. Is formed as a cross bridge. So cross bridge compulsory formation of the country. ATP hydrolysis of the cup. ATP hydrolysis again. ఎనర్జీ యూజ్ అవుతుంది ఎనర్జీ ఆల్సో లిబరేట్ అవుతల ఆ ఎనర్జీ కంప్లీట్లీ బైండ్ అట్ మయోసిన్ నెక్స్ట్ ఆఫ్టర్ ద క్రాస్ బ్రిడ్జ్ ఫార్మేషన్ ఆర్ యు అబ్జర్వింగ్ అండ్ యు గాట్ ద డిఫరెన్స్ బిట్వీన్ దీస్ టూ Here, are you observing that one? Here, this is called myosin, this is called actin. Both are having the equal length like this. Understood? Okay? So now, this is about the actin and the tilgotum. This is about the myosin and the tilgotum. Cross-bridge formation, either cross-bridge formation or kakshana. Now, the myosin is pulling that from the actin. Which one is pulling here? Yes, myosin is pulling that from the actin. How? What the, you know, actin mundu ovithrodu. The difference, E diagram, is also difference only. Clear up? This is called the mass, okay? Sliding, this is called sliding. Sliding of which one? Sliding of which one? Acting on which one? Clear up? Sliding quantity, which one? Myosin is pulling that one. Clear? So, Here, myosin is completely bind with actin, they are pulling, same here also, this side also, myosin head is bind with the actin and it is also pulling. And the two sides of pulling is takes place. Two sides of the pulling is takes place means, so I already said, between that one non-overlapped region is what we can call stretching. When the both actin filaments are come close with each other, Kamata, which one is it disappears? Plus, actin proteins already bind with the which one? Z-line. Actin is pulling and then automatically, actin attached to Z-line also? Correct. Now, the both Z-lines are come close with each other. Atta the students. Now, E myosin, they are pulling this one also, this myosin also pulling this side also. That's why both Z-lines are come close. H2 come close up, right? If both actin filaments are come close like this one. Sometimes it is also overlapped also either. Overlap also both. Which one is overlapped? Actin filaments. Three. If the both actin filaments are overlapped with each other, that is called maximum contraction or minimum?
Maximum contraction.
Clear up? So maximum contraction only H zone is disappears. Clear up? This is called muscle contraction. So muscle contraction I think. The muscle contraction, they are pulling on the muscles, mainly myosin, they want to relax. In relaxation time, again they release that one ADP and phosphates. In the relaxation time, if the myosin is releasing the ADP and phosphates, again actin is come to the original place. But repeated contraction, yavaga beko, immediately one more ADP will be comes. One more ADP will come that one and binds to that one the myosin. So ATP yavaga myosin jothege bind aagutho immediately ee cross bridge breakdown aagutte plus matte repeated contraction bekandre matte ide ATP is undergoes that one the which one now hydrolysis aagbeko hydrolysis aagirandre matte ee tarha cross bridge formation aagi matte recontraction is takes place as like a student ondu sathi contraction aagmele matte myosin the want to relaxation. In relaxation time only they can release the ADP and phosphate. Again, they're already ADP and phosphate here already bind aayitu, they can pull aayitu. Once the contraction only ADP and phosphates are removed from the myosin head, then cross bridge will be broken. But cross bridge will be broken out by kandre. Matte into the ADP beko, ATP will be comes and bind here. If the ATP will come and bind here only, both myosin and actin filaments are both are completely getting separated and they break down the cross bridge. Matte repeated contraction aagbekandre matte ide ATP again undergoes hydrolysis. By the hydrolysis again energy will be production takes place. Our energy name is helpful for the binding of the myosin with actin. ATP helpful for cross bridge formation. Other ATP is break down that for the cross bridge formation. Important students. Did you understand this concept? ATP beku for the formation of the brain, for the formation of the which bridge?
Cross bridge
formation of the ATP beku. ATP hydrolysis of it. ATP hydrolysis of it. ATP hydrolysis of it. So completely cross bridge formation of it. Plus ATP breakdown, mainly cross bridge breakdown of it. Cross bridge breakdown of it. Matte ATP bind of it. ಮತ್ತೆ ಇದೇ ಎಟಿಪಿ ಹೈಡ್ರಾಲಿಸಿಸ್ ಆಯ್ತು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಮತ್ತೆ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಓಕೆ ಈ ತರ ಎಟಿಪಿ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ಯೂಸ್ ಆಯ್ತು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಕ್ರಾಸ್ ಬ್ರಿಡ್ಜ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಎಟಿಪಿ ಮಾಲಿಕ್ repeated contraction of the muscles. Repeated contraction of the muscles. Illa, complete relaxation type of the complete relaxation. You can not put contraction, complete relaxation type of the first of all, brain is the impulse stop of the brain. Complete relaxation is a question. Brain in the yavaga impulse start stop avutho immediately action potential not generate and immediately the calcium ions are bind to the troponin, no? Calcium ions are binds to the troponin, no? Our calcium ions are will back to into the sarcoplasm, but the sarcoplasm in the it will be go to which reticulum? So calcium ions, once they get removed from the troponin, what will be happened? But the troponin will be come back to their original position. Original position will be again they are masking that one, the which binding sites? Myosin binding sites. And once the calcium ions are come out from the troponin will be completely mask that one, the myosin binding sites on the which filament? Actin. When the myosin binding site close, I think myosin can be bind with the actin. If the myosin cannot bind with the actin, which what is happened? Totally detaching is occurring. Cross bridge, complete detaching occurs. So when the cross bridge breakdown is occurs, now again these actin filaments are completely come to normal position. Actin filaments are come to normal position. And even Z line also come to. If the Z line is come to the normal position, means that is called muscle relaxation. So muscle contraction, muscle relaxation is totally under the control of our brain only. It will be stop the impulses from the brain itself only, the muscle contraction also will be stopped. Because calcium ions are play an important role in the muscle contraction and relaxation. Idhe calcium ions we are discussed in that one, the even blood coagulation only also calcium ions are play an important role. MBK students, calcium also one of the blood clotting factor. Foolish people try to climb long slope, try to climb madrena, see for what? Calcium. And which blood clotting factor? Which one? Fourth clotting factor in our blood clotting, that is called which one? Of calcium. Remember the form of the foolish people try to climb long slope after Christmas. Some people have fallen. Again, you want to repeat?